How's it going, everyone? It's your boy Dak908, aka the Dig Dug himself. And today, before we get into this episode of the, you know, the Onyx only run, I want to make a small aside and say that I'm going to apologize right out. I wanted to have this video out a long time ago. I just couldn't get it done. So much happening at the time, and even now the video itself isn't done. This is part one. I had to do part one just to let you guys know, hey, we're still doing this. I wanted to give you guys something. I haven't given you guys a single video since literally last year, so I want to give you this section of the run. It's actually still really good. I wanted to make a video at least for Crash Awake where you guys actively see me come up with all the things instead of me cutting a lot of things out and super cutting it to death. It was an 8-hour experience though, so even though this 20 some odd minute video is still 20 minutes, it's 20 minutes out of, I believe, 4.5 hours. So just know that I was throwing myself at the wall, and I was really trying to come up with different action and everything. So for the most part, the enjoyment of seeing me overcome such a challenge is still in here, is what I wanted to convey. It's just that it's going to be split into two parts, simply because I need to get you guys something while I work on the rest of it. And when I do get the rest of it done, I promise you guys I'll get it done by the end of this weekend. It will be out either before the end of this week or going into the following week on a Monday, as we usually have been doing this. But with that said, thank you all so much for coming and watching. I'm sorry for this long aside, but I just want to get that off my chest, letting you guys know that I do plan on getting the rest of this run out to you as soon as possible, and hopefully, fingers crossed, before Arceus comes out. So that means I'm going to be focusing on Pokemon instead of Moss Hunter for a little bit. Again, thanks so much, and enjoy the rest of the video. So we're going to stream for at least 2 hours today, or we're going to beat the gym. And if the gym takes 4 hours, then unfortunately we're here until 10 p.m. Not really, we'll just try again tomorrow. But we're going to try and beat the gym. It's going to take a while. That much I know for certain, because this is the gym that I was terrified to actually go against, because it's water. All right, let's take a look at these stats here. Oh, he's almost level 40, which is good. Gives us Sandstorm. But yeah, let's take a look. We're looking at ever so pitiful stats. 53 special defense is all we're really working with, and everything they hit us with is going to be 4 times as effective. Our moves consist of Curse, Bulldoze, Rock Slide, and Dragon Breath. We can probably only effectively curse once and pray that we're strong enough to like do damage to everything else. And I'm not gonna like continuously run and reset. Well, I'm gonna continuously run. I will eventually have to start resetting, because if not, I'll just like level up to the points where it's ridiculous. I feel like level 40 is a pretty solid level to fight Crash Awake at, or whatever we get when we get to, I guess, where we're getting to, if that makes any sense. And here we are, fighting Crash Awake. Now, I'm just gonna make it easy for everyone. The gym trainers didn't do anything, so we're skipping over them completely. This entire episode will be dominated by Crash Awake, the strategies that I came up with in attempts to fight Crash Awake, and what actually did end up working. Truth be told, without actually doing any research, I can't remember what worked. I want to say I got incredibly lucky, because it's going to take a lot of luck to actually get through through Crash Awake, because I mean, he's such a, like, in this particular run, he was the hardest trainer in the entire run. 100% hands down, the only one I've had to try over 10 times to actually beat. So Crash Awake is here, and let's see what our first strategy is. Sandstorm. Yeah, we have to learn Sandstorm. We're gonna learn Sandstorm. Okay, this is big. This is big. We need Sandstorm. Why do we need Sandstorm? Because it'll help boost our special defense in the sand. And in case Crash Awake has any Pokemon that's coming in with like Rain Dance or whatever, we can like knock that away. We can also learn Sunny Day. So that's also a potential thing we could probably do. Sunny Day reduces water power. Jeez, my brain stopped. Sunny Day reduces the effectiveness of water damage, or power of water moves. So that could possibly help us as well. I don't know which is which. Is it like, is it the benefits? Is it equal benefits? Is it like Sandstorm increases my special defense to the point to where it's the same as if they had a sunny day out and their attack dropped? You know what I mean? I don't know. We'll get rid of Dragon Breath. I'm pretty sure we can do the gym trainers, we can bulldoze Rock Slide. But when we get to Crash Awake, that's when we're going to really start thinking about what moves we actually run. if you guys are talking about like the movie's gonna use, I don't care what movie's gonna like. The actual water type attack that he uses does not matter. Okay, it absolutely does not matter. He's going to crush my heart and soul. It does not matter what it is. It could be freaking water gun. All right, and I can get erased with water gun. This is an Onix we're talking about, guys. So the plan on the first initial stretch is to bring the Citrus Berry, equip it to Onix, use Sandstorm immediately so that way I can have the special defense boost, and then I guess just rock slide every monster that he has. Pocket monster, that is. But nevertheless, the thing is, this plan does not work because this video is as long as it is, obviously. So let's just see how the fruits of that labor actually works. And it's also my first attempt at the guy to begin with, and I learn he has a Gyarados. Alright, blah 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 blah, whatever. This is gonna be the toughest one, for sure. This is going to be the toughest fight in the entire game. In my opinion, I feel like it's gonna be the toughest fight in the entire game. Crashwick has three Pokemon. He sends out a Gyarados. This is literally the worst Pokemon he could have opened with. The absolute worst. Because it's fake. It's fake. It's bait. Okay, he's like, oh, look, it's Gyarados. Dak, you can hit him with Rock Slide and it's going to be super effective. Yes, but I'm intimidated now. A Pokemon who has 45 base attack does not, I repeat, does not ever need to be intimidated. What does this mean? This means I have to curse. I have to take two turns before I even hit this thing once. Two turns before I even hit him once. Let's see how this goes. I got a Sandstorm. He used Grind. Oh, it did exactly half. It did exactly half. Maybe wait, this is Brian. I'm gonna die now. Oh no, I thugged it. GG's. Okay. It did 20? That's it? Oh boy. Alright, here we go, Rock Slide. He's faster. Minus one Gyarados is faster than this. Okay, this is tough, guys. This is gonna be... Yo, this is gonna be... Actually, you know what? No. We'll keep it. We're not gonna run the Citrus Berry strat. There we go. The Citrus Berry strat did not work. We did learn a couple of things. We learned that Sandstorm actually helps my special defense quite a bit, so I may use it some more. We also learned that Gyarados is going to be walking in and giving us a free Intimidate immediately, and we don't know whether we should or should not curse. Probably not, simply because the Gyarados is now faster than us, making it to where even if we do set up Sandstorm and do set up a curse, we can live both attacks, but we will still die by the follow-up attack. So now the real thing is, do we just live with the fact that we are minus one on attack? It is to be seen. Let's find out. Okay, so the Citrus Berry strat didn't work because we Sandstormed. Actually, we cursed. I think... Actually, no. Let's see. We're going to play with some values. Let's see how much damage we do with the Hardstone in the Intimidate. Yeah, we're going to Sandstorm, Rock Slide, Rock Slide. I think we can do that. But boy, it's going to be tough. Actually, no, we're not going to Sandstorm. We're not going to Sandstorm. We're just going to Rock Slide. No, whatever. We're Sandstorming. This entire run lives and dies on the Sandstorm. There's no way fans are buzzed about it. We have to Sandstorm. Because they're just going to brine. And then we're going to be at 42 HP. It straight up took us down to half again. It's ridiculous. Okay. So now we're going to Rock Slide. It's going to flinch. It's good damage. It didn't flinch. But it crunched. What a smart lad. Okay. Use super potion. Huh. Nah, we just rock slide it. I was trying to find a way we can exploit that, but we're not gonna find a way to exploit that. I don't know, maybe we could run the citrus berry. Quagsire. This is the one I was afraid of. This is the one I was afraid of. Oh no, we are in trouble. We are in trouble. We are in trouble. No strength is gonna do better than that. Yeah, we are in serious trouble. Oh boy. Quagsire is the problem. So there we have it. Our biggest roadblock on this particular fight will be this Quagsire. Not the floats awaiting in the back. Believe it or not, it's actually the Quagsire. We only get past the Quagsire twice. Spoiler alert. And the second time we get past the Quagsire, we actually win the fight. But the thing is, the amount of times we get to the Quagsire and end up failing is insane. He can hit us with literally anything he wants and do insane amounts of damage to us. Whereas, because he's a defensive Pokemon, high HP, high normal defense, and we're an Onix who has low attack and non-existent special attack, is going to be the hardest thing opening up this particular Quagsire. So we're just going to have to try a completely different strategy. Maybe. We're going to have to try the berry strat again. This time, we're not going to curse. Huge! Shout out to, like, this game and the love or whatever the heck. Don't heal. Perfect. Perfect. We're at 42 HP. Oh wait, Quagsire's the... I forgot, Quagsire's the problem. What do we do about Quagsire? Yeah, let's try buffing. No, not enough. Scald is too much. So setting up on Quagsire isn't going to work. We learn now that setting up on anybody isn't going to help at all, because they could just hit us with a special effective water attack that does 4x damage, and it doesn't matter if we have more attack to hit them with if they can kill us in less hits. So what do we do? I don't know. Actually, I do know. But maybe, just maybe, this one move can actually help us out. Maybe we get Screech back? I think we maybe get Screech back. Or do we double team spam? What do you think? Double team protect in Sam? Get rid of Curse for Screech. Odds are we're not gonna need the defense boost. They're just gonna hit us with special attacks. So Curse can go away for right now. We're probably gonna get rid of Bulldoze for strength, even though Bulldoze is stab, base 60 power. I think base 80 will do more. All right, we're gonna try this. We're gonna Sandstorm, do the Rock Slide, whatever, Scram Boogie Boo with Gyarados. Quagsire will come in. We're gonna Screech Quagsire. Actually, we need to live one hit from Scald first. Because I was thinking, if I get that Water Berry, he's gonna eat on the first water attack, right? Okay, cool. So first we Rock Slide. First we Sandstorm. He hits us with the water. We eat the berry. We Rock Slide. He hits us with it again. We Rock Slide again. I still don't think we're going to be over 42 HP. Because Brine, excuse me, Scald from Quagsire kills. I think we need to flinch. Yeah, we have to farm for flinches. We need to see some raw numbers. We have to farm. We need to hit Gyarados with the Rock Slide, get him to flinch. And then we need to hit him again because we will kill him. We need to get to Quagsire with as much HP as possible. That's what we have to do, as much HP as possible. Okay, so to sum it up, the plan now is to use Screech on Quagsire, let him hit us once, and then use Strength to hit him with as much damage we can actually give to a Quagsire in our particular case. On top of that, we must first not be hit at all by Gyarados. We must force straight flinches onto Gyarados going into Quagsire with as much HP as possible in hopes that we live two Scald attacks. And then we will see what happens. Quagsire one-shots us at 42 HP, which is like half. We have to be over half HP in hopes to maybe, I don't know, live it. But if we can't live it, then we're gonna be in a lot of trouble. It's exactly what needed to happen. Either we land a crit, land a flinch, or the love thing happens. We have three means to get rid of Gyarados. Now here's the real question. Sandstorm to protect ourselves. Screech to hurt him. Okay. All right. So what did we just learn? Dude, I have no idea. There's nothing we could really do. Hearthstone isn't going to help us because we still two-shot Gyarados anyway. We can't use the Hearthstone to Rock Slide on the Quagsire. And we can't even reliably use the Rock Slides to get him into flinch. We would have to get him to flinch like 5 times in a row. And that's not going to happen. Scald kills us at full health. No Sandstorm. And there's not a snowball chance in hell, even if we throw the Sandstorm up at full health, we don't die. It doesn't matter. Sandstorm doesn't matter. We can't use Sandstorm because, well, in Sandstorm, out of Sandstorm, it doesn't matter. What has to happen to Gyarados is, Gyarados cannot hit us. We have to Rock Slide, get the flinch, Rock Slide, done. Gyarados is done. We're just minus one. Dang, guys, what do we do? We hit Gyarados with two Rock Slides. He's two-shot no matter how we slice it. We can't get hit by him. Quagsire, if he hits us with anything, we die. We just fold. We have to set up a... We have to use one turn to set up Screech because we're minus one. To do any relevant damage at all. And then at full HP, he hits us and then hits us again. We can't two-shot Quagsire. Dang. We have to not get... Double team. We have to not get hit. That's it. Just don't get hit. Itty. That's your advice for everything, right? Oh, just don't do the thing that... The thing. We just have to not get hit. We have to learn double team.
And so begins our journey to actual success. It took us this long, so... Now we may have a shot at winning. Spoiler alert, we use this same strat later, but for the first time in forever, I decided to use a strat that relies heavily on luck, but when it's done properly, it can net us a win. And honestly, I believe it to be our best and single strongest strat we can actually perform as we stand right now. So let's see how it goes.
All right, here we go. Double team. Mm-hmm. You schmoovin' now.
Yes.
That's what I'm talking about. Again. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Miss again? Oops. It's okay. It's okay. That's okay. Double team again. Three. All right. Rock slide. All right. Miss. Thank you. Okay. Rock slide. Now, I want you guys to understand. That was a crit. GG's. I'm not switching to strength. I'm not going to screech. We're two rock slides in. We're gonna rock slide for flinches. It's not gonna do anything to Quagsire. See, it's not very strong. Scald, it hits. Damn. Okay, here's the plan. The plan is three double teams, rock slide the rest of the game. With Metronome, we will do more damage every time we do it, so we won't have to screech, we won't have to set up. Yeah, I think this is it.